Hi, this is Lady Days Vintage with a couple of my hauls. The first stop this morning was CVS. That was interesting. I got there just as church let out this morning, and that particular one is like in the center of about 8 different churches, so it was quite jam-packed. I had to let the Nature's Vitamin go. The coupons were beeping. It was creating a really big headache in the store, so I just left them sitting there. The cashier was so sweet. Okay, I did the pro enamel deal, and as you know, you have to break them up. You can't combine the coupons, so those are broken up. I mistakenly two of the $5 off ones were stuck together, which I didn't realize until she went to ring it, and then she handed it back to me. She said, "This is not going to work." So the machines are set so that they won't even take anything extra than what they're supposed to do. So we had to break them up into several different transactions. What I didn't realize is that also you had to do it with the Colgate. Now I had one. We didn't get a 75 cents off here in New York. We got a 35 cents off the Colgate in the paper. I think it was Smart Source this morning. Somebody stole my papers, so I'm a little bit ticked off at that. So I used that, and then in the Reinventing Beauty, they had a dollar off coupon, and I realized that it said the one off, but I didn't pay attention. I realized that it said only one on the Sensodyne, but I didn't pay attention to the Colgate, and I thought we can do both of the transactions at the same time. It didn't work that way, so it kicked it back, so I had to break those up into two separate transactions as well. The One Touch worked like a charm. The second $10 off was reduced to $9.98, but those were totally free. The Summer's Eve is buy one, get one free. We had the $2 off coupon, those, so it was $2.99, so I paid 99 cents for the two boxes of these. This was on sale for $2.09, the toothbrushes. I got those for my grandkids. I had a dollar off coupon. They also added to the buy 30, get 10. So I got that. I wish I had a couple more of them there, because they managed to lose them over the summer when they're here quite often. So maybe I'll go to another CVS and hopefully they'll have some. So I spent today out of pocket $12, so about $12. And then I went in with a $6 and a $4 extra care box, and then the coupons, and I got back, so basically everything was free because I spent $12 and I got back $14. Okay, so everything was free here. Okay, so I got the $10 back, two and two. So I rolled 10 and got back 14. Okay, so that's how that worked. That was CVS. I'll be back in a minute. Okay, this is my Rite Aid. I had three of the buy one, get one free of the speed sticks left, and I chose to do mine at Rite Aid as it counted towards the spend 100, get the 20 back. So I chose to do it there. I know others did it at CVS or whoever this morning, but these were on sale, buy one, get one free, but they weren't really on sale because they were like $3.79. Any event, the coupon, they made them free because, well, I had to pay 60 cents because she only took $3.49 off because these, the men rang up first, and the manager explained to her how to take the money off, and he said take $3.49 off, but these were $3.79, so I wound up paying 60 cents on four of those. So whatever. Okay, the glasses work like a charm. I found the spare pair. These are $9.99. you buy one, get one free. The benefit of buying three, as I watched another vlogger, I can't remember what her name is, and I do apologize. I think I even commented on her video yesterday. But the thing is that she says that the glitch in the system, well, I don't know, maybe it's not a glitch, that's just the way their system rolls. But if you buy three, it gives you the two rewards for it. Like the soft lips, I did that the other day. Unfortunately, they only had two, so I got the $2 back on that. So it was like getting one for free. But again, that added towards I think those added towards it. I'm not really quite sure. I'm almost 99% positive that the glasses did. So I spent out of pocket on this $13.55, if you can see that. That's what I spent out of pocket, and that was mainly for the glasses. I did use a $5 off on those, but then it was I had to pay $9.99 twice and then $4.99, so whatever that is, however it came out. And I think I used another discount in there, not quite sure. Okay, but it spit me back out $15 and $3. So $33. I spent $13.55 and I got back $33. Okay, so Rite Aid was very good to me today. Be right back. This is the deal with the glasses for the $15 up reward for Sunday, February 12th, is you can make the deal even sweeter with this coupon here that's in the diabetes book. Okay. So, and that's the coupon. Okay, this was my last haul for the day. This was Walgreens. The Dark and Lovely here, unfortunately, was $7.99. I know in most places it was $6.99, and then you got $5 back. And if you had the dollar off coupon, it made it just 99 cents. Here, unfortunately, I don't know why everything is always so much more expensive. But the thing is that I had this coupon here, which was part of a tear pad. And I can't even remember where I picked it up from, but this was $1 off of any one and $3 off of any two. The cashier used it twice. He scanned the coupon twice. I'm saying, well, why is he scanning it twice, right? But I didn't really pay any attention. Again, the stores are very crowded today, I guess because the weather is not as bad as everybody had anticipated it being. So it's real crowded out today. So he scanned it twice, and apparently it took $4 off as opposed to $1 off. Okay, as I'm looking at the receipt, I see a $3 and a $1. Okay, forgot where I was at. So in any event, he took off $4 for them, so which made those $3.99, and then I got $5 back on them. But I really didn't realize what he was doing until I got home. But I noticed that he did scan it twice. When I had these, I had them on the front hand side, so I really didn't pay attention to what it looked like. And then it dawned on me, well, how would they know whether you have the one or the two? I'm thinking the cashier has to enter the it in manually. Oh, well. Anyway, so that's what happened. These were in the paper today, the $3 off of any got-to-be products. My products were on sale for $1.74. Unfortunately, I can only use one of the coupons because it was not enough to use for the second $3 one. So I got these from Walgreens because they were on sale. The studio line from L'Oreal, we really have some great L'Oreal clearance items. These were on sale for $1.34. I had the dollar off coupon, which most of these L'Oreal coupons came from that J-Lo we got back in January sometime. So these are gonna be expiring towards the end of the month. So keep checking your Walgreens clearance and use them up before they're gone. So like I said, I want to spend in, 34 cents for those a piece. Did the same deal here, the Comex. I wanted to try this. It was buy one, get one free. And I had some Catalinas that I needed to get rid of anyway. So I got it. It was $2.99 and get one free. So what is that, $1.50 a piece? So I'm going to have an opportunity to use them. Both of the hair care products generated $5 back out of pocket. The first transaction, which was, my anniversary card to my husband. This is our anniversary. So I picked that up too. So the first out of pocket was $3.18, and that was basically for the card. And the 74 cents over that, because the card, most of that was from that. And then $1.79 tax, which made that $4.97, and I got back $5. Okay. This one, the total was Can you see that? Okay, that I can't even see it myself. Sorry about that. The total was $109 and $1.07 in tax, and which made it $216. I used the $8. I'm sorry, I forgot to mention that I used the $8 from the what was that last week? We got the $8 from, was it the Blink? Oh gosh, I can't remember. And it may have been the week before that, so it may have been the Blink. Yeah, so I used the $8 on each of these. So that's what happened. That was my shopping trip for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you like what you see, give me a thumbs up. As always, comment suggestions are always welcome. Be blessed. Be happy with who you are. And I, you know, just happened to be someplace last night and somebody just kind of like rubbed me the wrong way, and I didn't want to come off badly with the situation. But the thing is that, you know, we've all got our faults and we've all got our flaws, and we as adults know that you're supposed to do certain things and you're not supposed to do certain things. That's between that person and God. We can't monitor and police and do all of that stuff to everybody else. But then I'm thinking I'm monitoring, policing that, but this person did something. She wanted to talk about everybody. This one did that, and you know that not supposed to do a specific thing, and she's going to ask a question about, can you do that? You know daggone well you can't do that, but you wanted to start a dialogue about a person, and I thought that the group was going to be kind of like a learning experience. I probably won't be back if it's going to be like that. I'm not into that. Everybody has got something wrong with them, and people really need to spend time looking in the mirror literally than speaking badly about other people. And I don't get that. I really don't. Anyway, be blessed. Don't have time for the drama. Trying to learn, trying to build up a nice stockpile. And no, I'm not going back to perms. I'm still natural, still happy with that. These are going to be donated to somebody somewhere. I guess a couple of people in my family still use Relax. Are they Relaxes, perms? It's been so long. I've been natural for about 8 years now. So anyway, thank you so much. Bye-bye. Okay, I just have to add this. Kobe Bryant was asked last night, how did they ask him this? Did he know who Jeremy Lin was? He said no, he didn't know who he was. He had heard some things about him, hadn't seen anything about playing or anything else like that. Act very, very cavalier and nonchalant about it. I'd like to ask Kobe today, do you know who Jeremy Lin is? Welcome to the Knicks, baby. Bye-bye.